I know, really sad. I'll take it from Yemi Adebayo, and it's so disheartening because Taekwondo has the potential to do well at the Olympics. Chika Chukwumerugye has been doing so well also. I mean, just having Judge Ashu being a grandmaster shows you how deeply rooted he is in Taekwondo. We're not saying he cannot be impeached, but we're saying due process should be followed. And then Judge Ashiru has also come out to give his own side of the story. We've heard from Margaret Binga, we've seen the press statement, the NTF saying she's the new president. But where Judge Ashiru is not agreeing, then something is wrong. So it's time for the Minister of Sports, the National Sports Commission, whoever is in charge, to call both parties, say, for the interest of the sports Taekwondo in Nigeria, let's be friends, let's think about development and moving forward. I'll talk about a federation that wants to move forward, the Nigerian Wrestling Federation. They're looking at all that is going on at the Indian Professional Wrestling League, and they said they want to do the same thing. Oyewuchi, when Oduwani Adekunle was going, we're a bit worried. She's going to India, she's going to be with champions. But you see, it's showing now that she has the quality, and if we've done the right things here, who knows? Should have been a world champion a long time ago.
I agree with you totally. And it's better late than never.
Never.
You know, the Federation President, Daniel Legale, has seen it all. So we don't expect anything less from his leadership. And it is reflecting, you know, giving opportunities to the best wrestlers in this country to, you know, rub shoulders with the best in the world. And you see, the idea of replicating the best standard, the standard practice all over the world is the way forward. So we can't continue to play second fiddle because we have the talents, like you said. What we need is that level of administration.
That's right.
You know, to complement the talents we have. Yes. And Adekunle has made us proud. She went to the U.S.
That was her fourth fight against Lilia.
Yeah. Before the All-African Games, she was in the U.S., picked up
bronze, qualified
for the Olympics, went to the All-African Games, and she has been doing well moving from center to center. So, replicating whatever is happening in India, I think for me, is the way forward. Mm. Because we have a lot of Adekunles in this country.
That's right.
And if we have championship here, it will save us the cost of you know, sending wrestlers everywhere, getting the same opportunity to wrestle against the best in the world.
Yemi, this was her fourth fight, her fourth straight victory, and Yemi, she's doing it in style. Tomorrow she's going to be having her fifth fight. That fight will be done about 3 p.m. Nigerian time. And in India, she's gradually becoming the poster girl. Yeah, that's her opponent, Tatiana Kidd. And Adekunle says she has what it takes to beat her.
Yeah, I mean, the results just shows you the direction that the fight might just go. Four straight victories, technical superiority in most of those fights. You know, she's now the poster girl for Nigerian wrestling, and I'm so very happy to be associated with this great athlete. I'm hoping that she's properly monitored, you know, as we go into the Olympic year. And well, I always have to support what Oyewuchi has said. But there are many Adekunles in Nigeria. You just have to give them that opportunity. And if we have to stay with the Indian Pro League, you know, there's one thing about form. When you're on a winning streak and you stick to your routine,
that's right,
you tend to continue. And I see that happening. I see her going all the way. And who knows, you know, it's just so good. We're talking about our dance steps, displaying the Nigerian flag. I mean, some steps that you and I probably don't know how to. and we saw how the Indians were just, you know, hooked on her, looking at her doing that. For me, that even apart from the technical superiority and all that, that is victory for Nigeria.
That's right.
Let's now assume we have 5, 6, 7 Adekunles. And what is stopping us from having them? Opportunity.
I know.
Just give the wrestlers that opportunity, give them that platform. And I'm telling you, a lot of people will jump. I mean, she jumped at this. Yes, we know all the obstacles she had to cross to get to India. I mean, you're all these familiar sounding words, the cliche, lack of funds, this and that. And at some point, somebody said, okay, I won't deny this talented. Come and show us what you can do. And she has shown that. And, you know, I hope that this just is a springboard for not just only her, other wrestlers.
And a lot of lessons on here as well for the Nigerian Wrestling Federation, because we just can't keep saying no funding. Remember, they were supposed to go to Copa Brazil. Yeah. They missed out. Mm-hmm. Just imagine Adekunle missing out of this. What would we have been talking about?
It would have been a disaster. You know, everything, the benefits that we're trying to highlight here, you know, would have been a non-existent. And you see, this lack of funds sometimes baffles me, you know, because it's like we are in it. It's like living in the ocean and washing your hand with spittle.
I not say it?
There are so many, so many corporate organizations.
I know.
And Adekoye is a budding female wrestler. You know, so there are some organizations that will be gender sensitive.
Mm.
You go to them, you outline whatever, you know, benefits. We are talking about Adekoye now. And if a corporate organization had identified with her, then the mileage will also be there.
That's right.
You know, these are things that you should make them understand.
Yeah.
We should not wait for government all the time. Because there will be bureaucracy, issue of budget, drop in oil price, and whatever. You know, so we need continuity, and the way forward is to, you know, sell your ideas to the private sector. And if you can't do that, you always complain of lack of funds.
That's right.
A good product always sells itself. And that's what Adekoye has done. And I'm hoping this will continue. That's just the hope. I'm hoping, like they say, a 9 months pregnancy doesn't catch anybody by surprise. If you say you're surprised, then definitely something's wrong with you.
Guys are turning this show into things by moonlight.
you have a calendar. You know what's going to happen.
Yeah.
Sell your product. And once you have a good product, it sells itself with little or no advertisement.
I agree. I mean,
Adekoye is not really something you need to make people know about. We already know about her.
The girl that produced one of the top three moments of the 2014 Commonwealth Games.
Yeah. Exactly.
You know, so that alone, put it together, take her singing, her dancing, her gold medal. She won a gold medal in under 1 minute. What else? Well, you don't need a lot of English to sell that kind of play.
And if you go to YouTube, she's an instant hit. Just Google, put the name on it. A lot of things pops up, you know.
Nigeria Wrestling Federation, pay me and my guys. We're already showing you how to brand Adekoye Adekoye, not just for the Nigeria Wrestling Federation, all federations in Nigeria. You start thinking of ways. It should be part of the 2016 plan. Branding, 360 degrees branding, total package. Look at ways you can develop your athletes, make them brands, and think of ways to generate revenue from them. I feel so there will be all these talks of government, Taraba FC, and all of the talks that is not sweet to come and say on TV will actually reduce. Okay, let's go on a break now. I'll come back. There's still so much to talk about. We'll talk about football in Nigeria. We'll talk about the Minister of Sports and his love to transform what's going on with sports in Nigeria. We'll come back. We'll talk about that. I'm going over right back. Stay with us.